Well, ladies and gentlemen, we've got about two more fighters and we're going to take a short interval. We're moving on to the featherweight division. Let's bring to the cage first, in the blue corner, Gino Valuto.
Big smiles on his face. He's just won a title fight. He's got a belt around his waist and he'll be cornering Paul. That's a huge man to have in your corner.
It's always great to have a champ in your corner. And we watched that fight, he was super impressive.
He was very impressive. And it's always a good confidence builder to have a champ.
Right, ladies and gentlemen, introducing first, Buddy from the blue corner. He weighed in at 64.3 kilograms. Fighting from Guts and Glory. Please make some noise. Gino Valuto! And his opponent, he weighed in at 65 kilograms, fighting from Rio Grappling, please welcome Paul Roma! And our referee is Gordon Roma.
Here we go. Gino Valuto against Paul Ronga. Jason Pleasantries and they're off. Big head kick straight away from Ronga.
Ronga's also going to have a bit of a reach advantage. He's trying to use it with his
legs straight away, coach. He's already trying to use it. Teeth doesn't work. Valuto comes in straight away. Jumping into a standing guard. Trying to find the neck. Has to release.
I think he would have. Trying to go for the guillotine there, but didn't quite work out for him.
No, not the way they played. So a little mistake for both men at the beginning.
Just worked the ball fast. Going for the guillotine again, coach. Going for it again, but he hasn't got the arm locked. He's got the ground boots.
He has his making him carry the weight at this point. And he's quite comfortable just to walk to his corner to listen to what they say. Good position for him to be in.
He's really strong. Working on the body a bit here, maybe.
Now that guillotine is almost in there. He's had to give up an arm and now
he's out again.
Ronga looking very comfortable at the moment. Even though he's getting the receiving end a little
bit. He's carrying that weight up. It's nothing. Good kick again by Ronga.
You can see a welter really starting to build on the leader's ribs there. He's taken a couple hard kicks already, hasn't he?
Oh, those were quite... Oh, that's really hard to get.
working a nice combination moves from the edge.
Looking for the head kick again. It's a very good defense as well for a nice side kick from Long. Really using his legs all the way.
Very well. You can see Long has also been training with the guys from XKT as well. He also worked with the guys from here at Bethany. You can see that coming through. Not looking too comfortable at the moment. Mark is open, you can see he's breathing heavy.
Yeah, he looks a bit wary of those legs because he's taking quite a few very hard kicks at this point.
Yes, you might just see this fight because he might see going to the ground. Now Benito landing at Norway for a little bit.
Yeah, quite a good combo.
And he's working the counter quite nicely from the leg kick now. He's finding a move for that left hand. Rushes in again and rushes out.
It's got to be quick on him because he knows if he stays too long he's going to be taking those kicks again. Oh, and a good left there from Long.
Long is starting to use that reach again.
Oh, he feeds a few there though. Oh, and again, good right from Benito.
Long is just letting Benito come on his inside to fight him. And that's what the shorter man wants to do. Get on the inside, land the punches.
He wants, Long really needs to start using his jab a bit more and get going back to those kicks.
Long looks like he's a bit hurt. That's the end of the round.
This is probably a quick land, but it was the end of the round. On the back foot a bit towards the end there.
Benito landed a hard right hand there that looked like it had shaken Ronga a little bit. Ronga very, very lucky that ball went.
Well, once he got on the inside, Gino was landing some really good shots.
So very nice to see the guys standing and trading a bit of leather. Second round, maybe it'll go to ground. Maybe the guys will decide that standing isn't working for either of them. Although it was quite 50-50. Maybe going to the ground looking for some submissions now. Well, looking at the coaches of Benito, they look like they're quite happy to stay standing in this spot. Benito possibly might have flipped it because he did land a lot more than Ronga did.
Yeah, his output was a lot better. Not all of the shots landed, but he was definitely getting better over towards the end of that round.
Shot for the takedown, but now he's put himself in a little bit of trouble here.
Ronga really should be looking for a slam here. He had a good position.
He really should. It's the third time that he's out of that position.
He's landing some good punches up against the cage.
And now Benito's starting to run away a little bit.
He's putting with about 5 or 6 good hooks there. And a couple of good uppercuts too.
I think Ronga's looking tired. There's no power in those punches though. He's landing, but with no power whatsoever.
It's a big right there.
Both these men, it looks like they're just sparring at the moment. Both exhausted, nothing much landing. It's landing, but it's not hard.
There's not a lot of power in those punches.
Ronga in a world of trouble here. He is hurt. He's
taking big shots. And his movement's so quite noticeably broken.
And now Ronga drags Benito to ground. Benito in guard. Benito can finish this fight. He pushes up, lands some good ground and pound. And already Ronga looking for the triangle. He's got a leg up,
he's got those long limbs, and like you say, coach, he's working it in there.
He's gonna bring that right leg over and try and hook. He decides to leave it now. Ronga has moved around a little bit. Sorry, Benito has moved around a little bit. Hear the camp of Juno Benito just saying, watch out for the elbows, watch out for the triangles. There he goes again, trying to get that leg up for the triangle.
Referee Gordon's not going on down there. He
messed up the back, luckily, so it wasn't much going on. Good job from the position, but not really any extra. There's some landing, some nice hard hits. Longest punches really haven't got much behind him at this point.
Not at all.
That was a good kick though. His kicks are landing with a bit of power. He's got those long arms. Levers, and once you start swinging those, he's got a great chance. Even the cage, landing a couple of knees is wrong enough.
Leo pulls guard again.
He's going to try and hold him down here for the end of the round, and he does. Then there's a second.
So 50-50 again this time.
Pretty close round. Leo probably landed the better shot, so we'll try again.
Leo probably taking this fight so far, both rounds.
Two very close rounds, but yeah, maybe just slightly ahead on both.
Probably ahead on both. He's been working very nicely. He is a man with a bit more gas from the looks of things. Ronda looking very tired, and he's looking good.
Oh yeah, he's taking some big shots, and he looks to be feeling them a bit as we're in the second round.
Seconds left.
We're going to see a real big finish here. We want to finish this round big and leave that in the judges' mind.
Velino looking for it.
Here we go. Big punches.
I've got Velino. Possibly taking the first two rounds. Possibly a draw in that third round. Not much was in it.
Very, very close round. We've got the big finish from Velino, and the judges always like to remember the big finishes.
Judges definitely do like a big finish. But that was, in my book, that's Velino's fight.
I would give it to him. I'd give him all three rounds. Very close, but I still think he landed the better shots.
You could just see
managed
both
to
men.
Work his way in when he needed to.
Both men gave their all in their first round. Second round, you can see they were gassing a little bit. Third round, they were both just physically exhausted.
Oh yes, very tough fight for both guys. Very, very tired guys.
So we're over to the judges' scorecards. Let's see if we predicted this one correctly. Scored this one correctly, apologies. Both men exhausted.
Oh, yeah. It's really great men. Much love to the end.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's make some noise for these two fighters. What an awesome fight! This fight went back and forth. Shots were in from both fighters. And at the end of three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecard. All three judges score this fight a unanimous decision. All in favor of your winner.
Like you said, all three rounds did do a lot, and maybe more than enough to control. Got on the inside of Rogan and was able to land his shots with precision.
I think he landed the better shots in this. It was very close all the way through, but just he landed the better shots in the farm really needed. Excellent fight, bro. Excellent.
Very, very good fight. Well done to both of these guys.
Good heart from both of those guys.
This shirt is from our friends from Vandalist Apparel. Please go check them out on Facebook. Find them on Twitter. Awesome apparel, beautiful equipment. Gino, good job. Let's tell us about that fight.
It was hard, but it was nice. The fight was very challenging. It was nice.
Yeah, it takes a special breed to come in here, get punched in the face, and go, that was nice.